In this sixth parsha, the Torah tells us that Bilam went to curse the Bnei Yisrael. Hashem got angry at Bilam, so he sent an angel there to satan him. The donkey saw the malach, and he went into the field instead of the path that it was supposed to go, and Bilam hit the donkey. As the pasuk says, "Vayicharav Elokim ki olechu, vayitzeh malach Hashem badarach lesatan lo, v'hu rochev al atono shnei na'arav imo. ותראה האתון מלאך השם ניצב בדרך, וחרבו שלופה בידו, ותת האתון מן הדרך, ותלך בשדה, ויך בלם את האתון לצוטה בדרך. We said before satan. That the angel came there to satan him. What does satan him mean? In Hebrew, the word satan means devil. However, Rashi says that it wasn't a satan. It was a malach ha-rachamim, the angel of mercy, that came to stop Bilam before he sinned. The Sifrei ha-rachamim asked, how could it be an angel of mercy and also a satan? It doesn't make any sense. They answer that the donkey thought that it was a devil. However, it was really the angel of mercy. The Sifrei Chachamim learned this from the word lo, him. Now the Torah tells us that donkey saw the angel again and went to the side. Bilam's foot smashed into the wall, and then Bilam hit the donkey. Then the malach appeared again, and again, only the donkey saw it. Again. And the donkey, and there was no place to go. It was a narrow place, so the donkey went down under Bilam. And Bilam got angry and he hit the donkey. Hashem opened the mouth of the donkey, and the donkey said to Bilam, why are you hitting me? Bilam replied, what do you mean? You're not listening to what I'm saying. You're going there. I'm telling you to go there. Well, what's going on? Now again, what are you saying? Why are you accusing me? You don't see that angel over there? It's trying to kill you. Hashem showed Bilam the malach, and the malach told Bilam to go with the people and to keep the conversation a secret. As the pasuk says, ויאמר מלאך השם אל בלעם, לך עם האנשים ואפס את הדבר אשר אדבר אליך אותו תדבר. וילך בלעם עם שרי בלק. I have a question. Why did the Malach tell Bilam to go? I mean, after all, the reason that Malach appeared was because Hashem was angry at Bilam for going in the first place. Why would it tell him to go? It could have even misled Bilam into thinking, oh, Hashem wants me to go since the Malach told me to go. Also, if you were to say that Hashem doesn't want to mess with free will, then why didn't the Malach not say anything? Why do you have to tell him to go? Rashi says that not only do people have free will, but what they want to do, Hashem helps them do it. He assists them into doing it. He leads them in the path that they want to go. Bilam wanted to go with the people, so the Malach sent him with the people, told him to go there. He directed Bilam to there, as he wanted. Sforno says that the Malach said, Lech im anashim, go with the people, but be amongst them. Do not be a leader. You were planning on being a leader. No, I want you to go with them as they requested. Don't be the head, just go with them. The Ramban says that the angel told Bilam to go, but the angel was hoping that Bilam would end up doing tshuva and not sinning. Well, he was hoping he'd do this before he cursed, or he'd turn around somewhere in the middle and not end up cursing the Bnei Yisrael, that he would do tshuva. The Or HaChaim says that if the angel would have told Bilam not to go, and Bilam would have ended up going, then it would have been a big chilul Hashem, because Bilam is not listening to what Hashem commanded. Therefore, the angel had to tell him to go, so that there wouldn't be a chilul Hashem. Up until now is what the Mefarshim say. I have a different opinion. My opinion is that the Malach wasn't saying, Lechim Anashim, go, I'm commanding you to go. The Malach was saying to go, he didn't actually mean it. Like a parent says to a child. If a child wants to do something the parents don't want to do, then after a while of arguing, the parent changes his tactic. And they say, go, you know what, just go. You want to go? Go, have fun. I'll remember this, I'll miss you. Just go, have fun, and whatever, do what you want, I don't care. So the Malach was saying to Bilam, Lechem Anashim, go, just go, whatever, do what you want. Trying to show Bilam that he was angry at him. And that's not actually what he wants, the same way it's not actually what a parent wants when he tells a kid to go. In conclusion, we said that Bilam wanted to curse the Jews. Hashem got angry at Bilam, so he sent an angel to Bilam. The angel told Bilam to go with the people. We asked why the angel told Bilam to go. If the reason the angel was supposed to be there was because Hashem was mad at him. Rashi says that Hashem sends people in the way that they want to go. So Bilam wanted to go with the people, so the angel directed him in the way that he wanted to go. Sforno said that the angel told Bilam to go with the people, but to not be a leader, unlike before. The Ramban said that the angel told Bilam to go with the people, hoping that Bilam would do tshuva and not curse the Bnei Yisrael. The Or HaChaim said that the angel had to tell Bilam to go, because if he would have told him not to go, and Bilam would have gone anyways, it would have been a chilul Hashem. So he was forced to tell him to go. I said that the Malach told Bilam to go, but he didn't actually want Bilam to go. He didn't mean for that. He said it sarcastically, as in, Lechem Anashim, go with them, whatever, we don't need you, do what you want. He didn't, that's not actually what Hashem wanted. Shabbat Shalom.